In this training module, you'll be learning how to drive a BR Class 801 electric multiple unit. During this brief introduction, you will be taken through the critical driving controls and performing passenger operations. When you are ready, climb aboard. Take a seat in the driver's position, so that... For this introduction, you'll be completing a full loop of the circuit and performing passenger operations when you reach the next stop. Prepare the train for departure. To unlock the control desk, you'll need to insert and set the master key. The reverser is used to determine the direction of travel. Set the headlights, as this will let others around you know that this train is operational. To begin loading passengers, you'll need to open the passenger doors. It's time to depart. Close the passenger doors. This train features a combined power and brake handle, so to get the train moving, move the handle into the power range. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of braking force by moving the power handle into the braking range. First introduced in September 2019, the Class 801s were built as a replacement for the aging Intercity 125 and 225 sets, which were the primary trains used on the East Coast Main Line at the time. The Class 801 fleet were designed as purely electric multiple units. However, they feature a single 560 kilowatt diesel engine fitted to one of the coaches for emergency use. This 9-car variant of the class has a maximum power output of over 4,500 kilowatts and has a maximum operating speed of 124 miles per hour. You're now approaching the station, so prepare to slow down the train. Use the power handle to apply some braking force to bring the train to a gentle stop in the indicated position. Now that the train has stopped, you can open the passenger doors. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.
In this training module, you're going to learn how coupling operations are typically performed. Coupling and uncoupling is important both for freight and passenger operations. Different regions and trains have different methods of coupling, but the fundamentals always remain the same. You'll be operating a BR Class 66 locomotive and coupling and uncoupling to mineral wagons, which are typically used for transporting coal, ores, and other mining products. This locomotive can couple with either Buckeye or Hook type couplers. Before you couple, you should inspect them and ensure that they're in the correct position. Attempting to couple when couplers are in the incorrect position can cause damage or derailment. Now let's head into the locomotive and couple to the wagons. You'll be backing up to the wagons, so set the reverser to the reverse position. Keep the brake control in release until you can see the brake pipe control needles are reading 5 bar, pointing upwards. This will release the brakes fully. Watch the brake cylinder, or BC gauge, to see it gradually reduce to 0, which tells you that the brakes are now fully released. Apply some throttle to get the train moving. The external camera provides improved visibility when reversing. Slowly, come to a stop just in front of the wagons. You need to be close enough to allow coupling. Ideally, the buffer should be touching. Couple the wagons to the locomotive. You can either do this on foot or use the external camera. Good work. Now, change direction with the reverser and bring these wagons to the indicated location. Now uncouple the wagons, either on foot or using the external camera. Change direction with the reverser and come to a stop in the indicated sighting. That concludes this module. Remember, this process might differ slightly depending on the region and rolling stock. If you're ever unsure, check the training modules.